Hey my friends, welcome back. Yeah, as you can see in today's video, we do a landscape painting. This is a Texan landscape with some blue bonnets. Yeah, I'm grabbing some brushes, you can see here. Using my palette to premix the colors that we're gonna use for the sky. 7 colors as usual. Links to the materials that I use are in the description box down below. This is a 30 by 40 centimeter HDF plate. I'm using some linseed oils to oil out the painting surface to prevent the color from getting sucked into the painting surface too quick. Yeah, and then start to build up the sky, as you can see here. The first thing is don't mix your colors too thin. You need to make sure that they are thick enough to really cover the white of the canvas here. And then the next thing is here, really important, you need to use different brushes for each single color. And this really kind of helps to really prevent the colors from getting muddy on your brush. And this is basically the main tips and tricks I can give you here. I see I'm switching back and forth the brushes, blending quite a bit, also kind of blending while I'm painting. I premixed kind of a set of colors before, but I'm still feel a need here and there to kind of intermix colors in between, as you can see here. I'm using this purplish blue color here, partially mixed with this orangey color to really get a nice transition between those, this bluish color, purplishy color, and the orangey color we mixed before. And I'm also using see here, this whitish color, this also this yellowish color here. Now kind of a time lapse. It took quite too long switching back to show you the details. I kind of build up those very fine cloud parts in the back. You can see here. Again here, I'm using another brush with another very bright color we have here. Again, kind of blending while I'm going, mixing the color into the still wet surface that we have here. And then we finally start to build up the the sky color itself by applying the color. If you like to see this video here in the full-time version, check out my Patreon, link is somewhere down below here. Where we have over 80 full-time tutorials, including this one here. I'm gonna show you the whole process of color mixing, applying the color, underpainting, until we have this finished painting here. Make sure to check it out. So, go on, painting the upper part. See, I'm constantly mixing in more and more of this darker bluish color here. They have a really nice transition between this a bit lighter color on the left and this a bit more dark one on the right side. Again, I'm using fresh brushes, kind of pre-blending before. You can see here this very soft brush. Again, links to the materials that I use here, including the brushes, are in the description box down below here. And then I grab a larger brush, again with no color to it, and start to kind of fine blend those areas. And this is another tip for you, when you need to blend large areas, just take a larger brush. This really helps to kind of smooth out the painted area. You know, I'm bringen die Mountains in the back. Also really make sure that you kind of make a really soft transition between the line of the mountain and the background color. Then I mix just one green color. It's kind of the underpainting for the rest of the painting. Also really see that I'm using in some areas a very thin layer of color. It's kind of a dry brush technique. Rubbing over the surface and applying the color very thin in some areas. It's not a selection for the second layer. I'm starting to build up those additional colors on the sky, those darkish clouds here. It's a very simple way. I'm just slapping on the color and a very rough way as you have seen before. Then I'll just go back and grab a clean brush, this time a bit of a stiffer one, and start to rub this bluish color into the background color. With this simple trick you can basically build up very quick, very smooth looking clouds. Same goes for the upper part, see? Very randomly put on those darker areas, and then I just rub it in. You know, I'm mixing the color for the greens in this painting here, using very ragged old decker brush. This may seem now a bit weird, but to get the impression of this sunset painting color scheme, you need to have some reddish color behind those trees. And that's what I applied before. I'm putting this reddish color before, and then I start to add those darker reddish and greenish colors. You can see slowly building up. This this tree here. I'm adding volume to it by going darker, adding some branches here and there. You can see some dots, some just a ton of details to really kind of make it look better, more realistic. Do this by using small brushes, of course, obviously, but just really to make sure you cut this. Then I'm mixing a bit of a lighter color and start to kind of add even more volume by kind of flashing out areas of the tree. It's kind of a special brush here. It's kind of thinned out on the top so that we can really easily just dot on some colors. Again, I'm using the first layer of color, kind of dry brush glaze layer beneath. I'm using the same brush here for the tree details on the left. See, again, I'm using this reddish color before. Then I'm using this decker brush to add basically the structure of the tree, including this greenish color, of course. I grab a small round flat brush and start, not flat, round brush and start to build up the trees, tree details, the branches. And you see, I'm not painting them through. I'm just hinting them here and there, especially in the upper areas. Also adding some blue colors to repeat the colors of the sky again in the landscape itself. And here now I'm thinning down the color heavily, this greenish, brownish color, to add just another layer of color to this green we have in the front. Even going a bit purplishy, bluish, kind of. And I'm just stippling over this whole thing. It's still wet. Some more colors. Again, with this thinned out brush here. That's really perfect for adding some grass details. Even using a fan brush in there, on the foreground, to really add even more little dots, little grass bits and pieces here and there, to really get in those grassy details. And then I let the whole thing dry for a couple of days and start to build up. Now I'm gonna try the blue bonnets. basically just two colors, a darker blue, lighter blue. And it's obvious, but just really to make sure that you don't forget this. In the foreground, I know it's obvious, but really to make sure they need to be larger, of course. Therefore I start with the foreground, start to establish basically the rough shape of those flowers here. With really very random looking brush marks. And then I'll go back and add those more lighter whitish colors here. Then I even start to build up more details, adding more lighter green colors for some single bits of grass here and there. In the background I'm getting smaller with the size of the flower itself. Again, putting in first the blue color. See here. Then I'm adding this whitish color. Again, very random shapes, sizes, forms. Partially blending into the still wet blue color here and there. Yeah, that's the finished painting. Perhaps you might also like to check out this video here, where we have another kind of similar landscape painting. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, that like button, and see you next time. Bye.